Live from Chaitix Technology Week 2021, I have with me James Carter. He is Chief Security Officer of LogRhythm. We will have a conversation with him about LogRhythm's Chaitix participation, rise in cyber attacks, and a lot more. So let's welcome James. Hi, how are you?
Good.
How is it going on Chaitix?
It's great. We've really enjoyed our time here and get to meet and interact with a lot of different customers, partners, and things like that. It's a new conference for technology, so we're happy to be here.
Yes, right. So when you talk about LogRhythm's participation at the event, why is it important for the company to participate?
I think it's important on a number of different levels. I think on one level, it's important for myself and some of the other executives to come over and engage in territory, in region, with our teams here, some of which we've met before, some of which we've never met before.
Right.
And so I think that's a really important aspect. And then obviously from a cybersecurity perspective, we're a premier organization in that space. So it's a really great opportunity for us to come here and showcase that, showcase the difference that we make for our customers. And so that's why I think it's really important for us to be here.
That's excellent. We know that cyber threats are evolving, and there's a huge rise in cyber attacks since the pandemic has started. How should organizations prepare themselves to combat those cyber attacks?
It's a great question, because I think the first thing an organization has to do is understand what cyber attacks they may be exposed to. And part of that is understanding your business, understanding why it operates, what's important for your business, model that against the threat actors that would have an interest in that, so you get a really clear understanding of your threat landscape, of what you could get compromised within your organization, as well as the attacker and their motives and methods on how they compromise. And I think that combination will provide CISOs with clear understandings of what they have to protect against. And then you don't want to have to respond to something, and you know, for the first time, right? So make sure you have a plan, make sure you have processes in place, make sure you have technology in place, so that way, and practice that. Make sure you practice before the actual incident actually happens. And so I think all those pieces are really important for CISOs to do to better understand and respond to these types of attacks.
Yes, right. Being the Chief Security Officer, what do you think, how CISOs gain a comprehensive advantage of security threats within an organization?
I think it goes back to just what I said just a minute ago, which is understand the business.
Mm-hmm.
I think CISOs have a hard time. They think that they know security, so they come in and they say, I know security, I'm going to do this way, this is how it's going to go. But really, every business is unique, every business is different. There are different things that are more important to the business, and so one of the first things that I do, in addition to the modeling exercise I mentioned at the beginning, is I actually conduct a business impact assessment and look at what are my most critical assets, where if it went down, it would mean revenue generation stops, it would mean our business stops to operate, safety concerns, all these, and then you rank them in order, and then you protect against those most important assets. And I think that is what CISOs have to do, which traditionally I think they're really poor at doing that. And then you marry the model with what's your most important assets, and then you build your defenses and your protections based on that.
Yes, that's correct. Talking about the investment in cybersecurity, should investments in cybersecurity evolve? How can the CISO convince the organization to invest more in this area?
I'm hoping in today's day and age you don't have to convince anymore. I mean, we've seen obviously the media has helped us out with all the cyber attacks and the breaches and the coverages of those.
It's a hot topic.
It is a hot topic. Yeah. It is a hot topic. And, you know, it's funny. I've been in this industry for almost 25 years now.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it kind of ebbs and flows. There's these spikes of activity where you have massive breaches. The news makes the news. All of a sudden, CISOs get a lot more investment. And then it kind of like levels back off, and then you have another massive breach and kind of follows the same cycle. So I think we're still riding the, you know, server wins cycle right now. And so I think investments, you don't have to convince anybody anymore, but I think what you have to do in those down periods is educate and raise awareness of things and relate cybersecurity to the business.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I meet with our board regularly. but take a look at that, educate them on how this risk actually impacts the bottom line of the business, and without coming to them with a bunch of security jargon or things like that. But as long as you educate them and make them aware of the risk or the impact and influence of what that could do, as well as the benefits it could be to be ahead of the cybersecurity game, it kind of speaks for itself. So as long as you can marry the business side of it together, you shouldn't have any problem in today's day and age getting budget. And security is still fairly new. Our budget is still continually increasing over the past decade or so.
Yes, that's true, and that's quite interesting. And we hope that with the increase in cyber attacks, everyone remains safe, all the organizations remain safe, and they have those capabilities to combat the cyber attacks.
Yeah, and I think it's just to add on, it's really interesting. I used to work for like a premier incident response company responding to intrusion all across the globe. And I used to tell them, the best way to get cybersecurity budget is to have a breach. And no one wants to go through that, but at that point in time, you kind of get like a open check to what you need. However, you can still leverage some of the other things and situational awareness of the other attack vectors, but really it just gets back down to business risk and what cybersecurity means and how does it align to that.
Yes, right. Thank you so much for being here with us. It was a pleasure talking to you, and we hope to have you again. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned to TechX to know more about what is happening at Jitex Technology Week 2021. Goodbye.